Something that Mrs. Claus asked me to hand out to you guys. But I'm not quite sure if anyone in this room has been good this year. This is a heavy bag. I think it's full of coal. Who's been naughty this year? Raise your hand. Ah, Mary Henry, of course. I myself will have to raise my hand. Who's been nice this year? Who's been nice? There you go. Very good. God bless you. I'm going to come around. I've got some special goodies from Mrs. Claus before we sing some songs. So, Merry Christmas to everyone. If there's something on your list you want this year, don't hesitate to ask. Because I'm the one who can get it for you. Saint Nick. That's right, I go by many names. Who knows some of the many names that I go by? Saint Nicholas is one of them. Mr. America is another one. What's that? Santa Claus, Joe Blow from Idaho. What else? What's that? Daddy Christmas. Kris Kringle. I should be... There you go, this is for getting it right. Merry Christmas. Who else has got one of my many names?
Mr. America?
Mr. America, that's right. What else?
Santa.
Santa? Sure, Santa. That's like Santa Claus.
Mr. America, again.
Sure.
Mr. Exercise.
Mr. Exercise. You know, I look a lot like the guy that does the exercise class in the mornings, but that's not me.
But can you add the river, kid?
That's my brother. He's a lot nicer than I am. And I'm a nice guy.
No lying.
Was it a holiday Christmas special? Your two front teeth? A facelift. She wants a facelift for Christmas. Here you go, Merry Christmas. Care for a candy cane, my friend? No, okay. Candy cane? Yeah, why not? Let's rot our teeth out together. If we're gonna do it, let's do it together. Mr. Doc, you've been a good boy this year. It makes a good bookmark. Merry Christmas, Doc. Don't eat these poinsettias, they're poisonous. Merry Christmas. There you go.
It's a body build.
Why, thanks. Is that the one you want? She wanted to see my face. I said, I'm wearing it on the front of my head. That's right. In Russia, I come at New Year's. And I'm known as Father Time. You know why I do that? Because you guys got me in December and here in America. A man can only work so much. Merry Christmas. Anyone else? As I come around, let me know if you want a candy cane. Paul, come on in here.
I want a cake.
Wandering the halls like some lurking thug. Come in here and get some Christmas cheer. Oh, I didn't give you one. Where's the cane, she says. Is that any way to greet the one and only Santa Claus? Gimme, gimme, gimme. Yeah, we'll see what's in your stocking. Anyone else? Merry Christmas. Mr. Bruce, did you not get one? Wait, this you get a good one. Bruce has been a really good boy this year. Wow, these are all a little beat up. I'm going to get you the good one. There you go. Merry Christmas, Bruce. The best percussionist Fleshing House ever had, Bruce. Hello, Paul. Merry Christmas to you. Have a seat, my friend. Is that any way to greet Santa? How you doing, fatso? Here you go. There you go, my friend. Cheers. Let's go. On guard, you. On guard. Have at ye. Salute. Here's mud in your eye. Oh, my fat stomach can't get past this chair. Oh, you know how Santa gets so fat, right? Thanksgiving is his favorite holiday. Not Christmas. I eat an entire turkey. Merry Christmas. Hey, can I interest you in a candy cane? Yes. Anyone else? Did you get one? Did you want one? Well, Merry Christmas. That'll be $2.95, please, plus tax. Shipping and handling. Did you want one? There you go. Merry Christmas. Send me one? Yeah, you can send me one. Wait, these pants are falling down. I lost some weight since last year. Yeah, my belly's falling forward. The logistics of this suit is a nightmare. You have no idea. I'm wearing six layers of I don't know what. Sorry about that. Yes, I have gained. Well, you know, come Thanksgiving, I eat a ton of turkey. I eat a whole farm of turkeys, and I get all fat and jolly. So when the kids come up to me in the mall, I can go, ho, 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 and shake my belly full of jelly. Because otherwise, if I'm skinny, they're going to think I'm a fake. And everyone here knows I'm no fake. I am the one and only Santa Fleshing House, right? That's the long end of it. Here, stir your wine with this candy cane. Merry Christmas. Hello, Tony. This is only for good girls and boys. I know everybody's name. All right, that one's on loan. Granted, you're a good boy next year. But that's sure not for this year. Hello, hello. We took a great picture together last year. Do you remember? Yeah, we'll have to take another one this year. Hey, gang. The gang's all here. Oh, this one's caught in my... This one's caught in my beard. Have you been a good girl this year?
Nope.
No. Well, at least she's honest. That's one less lie you've told this year. Merry Christmas.
Can you sit on my lap?
I want to do that too.
I got a bowl full of jelly. You might just slide right off and hit the floor. Merry Christmas. Oh, yes, of course. Ethel Maybloom has been a very good girl this year. She's been volunteering in the activities department all year. We want to say thank you very much. Round of applause for Ethel Maybloom, the woman with the most energy I've ever met. Here you go. And this is all you get for all your hard work. A 5-cent candy cane. Ah, sucker. I'm just kidding. We love you, Ethel. Merry Christmas to you, Bridget. That one's on loan until next year as well. Just kidding. Jerry, love of my life, apple of my eye, cream of my coffee. That candy cane's for you, sweetheart. Sugar in my coffee, yes. Merry Christmas, guys. Okay, so who didn't get a candy cane? You didn't get one? Merry Christmas. This one's for you.
I swallowed the whole turkey. I didn't even chew.
I'm sure. Hello, Robert Coptic.
Wait at it.
Merry Christmas. Have you been a good boy? Have you been a good boy?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah.
Oh, my God, again.
That candy cane.
Oh, okay. Thank you, Santa.
Merry Christmas.
I like your pictures. My sister's on your pictures are great.
Good.
She's down in Virginia and she got the picture.
Yeah, if you need more, let me know.
Okay.
If you need more.
I appreciate it.
Did you want to? Yes, enjoy.
Hello there.
Don't let it spoil your appetite now.
Merry Christmas.
You too.
Remember what Mommy and Daddy say.
Oi, oi.
Ho, 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 ho.
Thank you.
Can I have some
juice?
Hot dinner, sure.
Yeah, I'm about to give birth to a 3-pound pillow. Oh my goodness. This is what happens when Santa suits are being made over in China now, you see? They've shipped the labor overseas and now the Santa suits are falling apart. Yeah, that's right. Santa's workshop has been subsidized and this suit doesn't quite fit anymore. You didn't see that. So you guys want to sing some Christmas carols, my favorite part of Christmas? Come on, let's sing a song together. Come on. Whoever sings the loudest will get the $10,000 prize. How's it?
Thank you for the snow.
Everybody have a Christmas carol book?
Everyone have a Christmas carol book?
Yes.
I'm going to set my candy canes here, but I got my eye on you guys. Hey, you didn't get a candy cane, did you?
I did. I put it away.
Oh, I didn't give you one. Did you steal from Santa?
You gave me one.
She stole from Santa. I can't believe it. What song do you guys want to sing? Someone shout out a song.
White Christmas.
White Christmas.
Didn't snow yet.
We'll start at the beginning. That's a good place to start. Good place to start at the beginning.
Hey, Sandy, you start it off.
Okay, let's pick a key here. I'm dreaming of a white Christmas, just like the ones I used to know, where the treetops glisten and children listen to hear
sleigh bells in the snow.
Ho, ho, ho!
I'm dreaming of a white Christmas with every Christmas card I write. May your days be merry and bright, and may all your Christmases be white, and your credit cards not be denied and declined. Hey, Merry Christmas!
Katie, do we have a music to go along with this?
No.
Okay, a cappella. How about, you want to sing Rudolph? You know Dasher and Dancer and Prancer and Vixen, Comet and Cupid and Donner and Blitzen. But do you recall the most famous reindeer of all? Rudolph the red-nosed reindeer had a very shiny nose. And if you ever saw him, you would even say it glows. All of the other reindeer used to laugh and call him names. They never let poor Rudolph join in any reindeer games. Then one foggy Christmas Eve, Santa came to say, Rudolph, with your nose so bright, won't you guide my sleigh tonight? Then how the reindeer loved him as they shouted out with glee, Rudolph the red-nosed reindeer, you'll go down in history. Bum, bum, bum. Hey, all right. Yes, Mrs. Claus. I'm married to Mrs. Claus, of course. She said, I didn't know you're a married man. Let's sing a couple more, shall we? Tis the season, isn't it?
What's next?
Frosty the Snowman. We'll sing the first few verses. Tony, come up here and help me. You dancing fool, you. Frosty the Snowman was a jolly happy soul, with a corncob pipe and a button nose and two eyes made out of coal. Frosty the Snowman is a fairy tale, they say. He was made of snow, but the children know how he came to life one day. There must have been some magic in that old straw hat they found, for when they placed it on his head, he began to dance around. Oh, Frosty the Snowman was alive as he could be, and the children say he could laugh and play just the same as you and me.
All right.
Second verse, same as the first.
That day. So he said, let's run and we'll have some fun now before I melt away. Down to the village with a broomstick in his hand, here and there and around the square, saying, catch me if you can. He led them down the streets of town right to the traffic cop, and he only paused a moment when he heard him holler, stop! Oh, Frosty the Snowman had to hurry on his way, but he waved goodbye saying, don't you cry, I'll be back again someday. Oh, thumpity thump thump, thumpity thump thump, look at Frosty go. Thumpity thump thump, thumpity thump thump, over the hills of snow.
Hey! Wow, these pants are falling off.
Take it off, take it off.
Stop it, you gotta watch.
I'm getting a request to strip.
Yes.
No, no, no.
Santa, would you like to visit the residents that are in the dining room?
That sounds like a good idea.
I'll continue on with this.
Katie's gonna melt your hearts with her angelic voice, and I'm gonna visit the residents in the dining room. I shall return. Merry Christmas.
Hey, only Santa gets to rub this time. This ain't a Buddha doll.
Some people are digging ditches with shovels, man. We got a good job. I mean, you're goofing around, you know? I'm just joking. I'm doing this, but some people are digging ditches for their... Here I am, playing Santa.
Take it down this way. Let's see.
Ho, 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 ho.
Where's up here?
Hey!
Little Santa's in the room, buddy!
Happy New Year! I just wanted to swing by and say, how's dinner? Because I'm hungry. I'm always hungry. I got a bowl full of jelly. I'm sick of jelly.
You must have a pretty good picture.
Merry Christmas, everybody. If there's anything, thank you. Yes. I mean, wait, who's Josh?
You are.
I did not just respond to that name. Santa's the name. Christmas is my game. If there's anything you want for Christmas, please. Hesitate to ask. Have a Merry Christmas!
Hello everyone. Thank you for coming to our Christmas service, Christmas Eve service. We're thankful that you were able to come today and share with us as we celebrate this holiday. Today the service will be conducted by myself and Reverend Thompson. Reverend Thompson is going to lead us in a word of prayer to begin.
Let us pray. Dear God, we thank you for the gift of your Son who came down in the midst of need, in a place which was unspecified, was not known to be of any importance at all, who came to be with us as we are, in our conditions, in our needs. We thank you that he has called us to follow him, to serve and to care. And we ask that we may participate in his glory to the end. These things we ask in his name. Amen.
This is how the birth of Jesus Christ came about. His mother Mary was pledged to be married to Joseph. But before they came together, she was found to be with child through the Holy Spirit. Because Joseph, her husband, was a righteous man and did not want to expose her to public disgrace, he had in mind to divorce her quietly.
But after he had considered this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you shall give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins."
All this took place to fulfill what God had said through the prophet. The virgin will be with child and will give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel, which means God with us.
When Joseph woke up, he did what the angel of the Lord had commanded him and took Mary home as his wife. But he had no union with her until she gave birth to a son, and he gave him the name Jesus.
After Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea, during the time of King Herod, Magi from the east came to Jerusalem and asked, "Where is the one who has been born King of the Jews? We see his star in the east and have come to worship him." Right now, we would like you to join together with us in song as we sing "We Three Kings of Orient Are." You will see that the words will be up on the screen. If you are able to, you can stand with us, but if you need to, you can stay seated. Thank you very much. When King Herod heard that he was disturbed, when King Herod heard this, he was disturbed, and all Jerusalem with him. When he had called together all the people's chief priests and teachers of the law, he asked them where the Christ was to be born. "In Bethlehem, in Judea," they replied, "for this is what the prophet has written. But you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah. For out of you will come a ruler who will be the shepherd of my people, Israel." Then Herod called the Magi secretively and found out from them the exact time the star had appeared. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and make careful search for the child. As soon as you find him, report to me so that I too may go and worship him."
After they heard the king, they went on their way, and the star they had seen in the east went ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were overjoyed.
On coming to the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshipped him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold and of incense and of myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to go back to Herod, they returned to their country by another route. Please join us as we sing Silent Night. I am going to turn down the lights, and if you would hold up your candle as we sing this next song.
Thank you.
May someone please get the lights for me? When they had gone, an angel of the Lord appeared to Joseph in a dream. "Get up," he said. "Take the child and his mother and escape to Egypt. Stay there until I tell you, for Herod is going to search for the child to kill him."
So he got up and took the child and his mother during the night and left for Egypt, where he stayed until the death of Herod. And so was fulfilled what the Lord had spoken by the prophet, "Out of Egypt I called my son."
When Herod realized that he had been outwitted by the Magi, he was furious, and he gave orders to kill all the boys in Bethlehem and its vicinity, who were 2 years old and under, in accordance with the time he had learned from the Magi. Then what was said through the prophet Jeremiah was fulfilled. "A voice is heard in Ramah, weeping and great mourning. Rachel weeping for her children and refusing to be comforted because they are no more."
After Herod died, an angel of the Lord appeared in a dream to Joseph in Egypt and said, "Get up, take the child and his mother and go to the land of Israel, for those who were trying to take the child's life are dead."
So he got up, took the child and his mother, and went to the land of Israel. But when he heard that Archelaus was reigning in Judea in place of his father Herod, he was afraid to go there. Having been warned in a dream, he withdrew to the district of Galilee, and he went and lived in a town called Nazareth. So was fulfilled what was said through the prophets, "He will be called a Nazarene." Let us pray. Dear gracious Lord, thank you for your word, Lord God. Thank you for telling us, Lord, so many times of your son's coming. Thank you, God, that you sent us a Savior. May we praise you today and remember always, God, that our salvation lies in you. In the name of Jesus, amen. If you would take with me your responsive reading sheets that I handed out before we started the service, they're on the chairs, empty chairs. As you see, there's some bold print. I would like you to read the bold print together, and I will read the regular print. "Because you were willing to humble yourself, to become human, to make yourself nothing." "Because you were born poor, weak, and homeless." "Because God, out of his great love for us, sent you to live among us and die for us." "Because those infant hands of the babe in the manger were pierced on the cross as you bore our sins." "Because you, the infant in swaddling clothes, are our great high priest, who was tempted in every way, just as we are, yet was without sin." "Because God has raised us with you on account of your sacrifice, seating us with you in the heavenlies above all powers and authorities. Because you are the promised Messiah, the creator of life, the King of kings and Lord of lords, the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. Because you, the root and offspring of David, and bright morning star, have promised to come again soon. Amen. Let us join together in one more song. We're going to be singing Go Tell It on the Mountain, which is a personal favorite of mine.
Want to dry? With professional quality results, but 50% less.
Sorry, I'm using the internet, and unfortunately there's ads. I'm very sorry about that. This is not Go Tell It on the Mountain. Here we go.
Let us pray. The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all, now and forever. Go in peace. Serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Amen and amen.
That concludes our service for today. We all wish you a very Merry Christmas. You can leave your lights in the box on the podium on your way out. Thank you.